Call 403-526-9720.
Calling 403-526-9720.
Hi, is this William?
Speaking.
Hi, this is Tom.
Tom?
Tom Fugier.
Yes.
I saw one of your cards today at the coffee house.
Yes.
And I tried to send an email to the email address.
It's wrong.
Okay, so you're already aware.
It doesn't have my name on it either. Except in small print on the back.
So, might have been done in haste, I guess.
Yeah, my email address is www.
That would make more sense.
It would.
Yeah. Right on. There was an email that I wanted to send you, I guess, just to sort of check on some stuff. But, I mean, now that I got you on the phone, I don't know, we could just chat.
Mm-hmm.
What do you think about the report that Kara Security did being released to the public?
The report for the CCDA?
Yes. Right. I mean, there was an interview where Les Schwab told the newspaper it will be forthcoming with the results of the investigation. Why did that change?
You would have to ask him. I don't know.
But, I mean, you're the guy on the board who is with the CCDA and the city council. We, you know, I'd think that you would sort of know about what was going on there. Do you recall saying at a city council meeting that you had seen me in the hallway outside of a meeting?
I did see you outside the hallway.
Yes, you did say that, right, and you did see me there. Do you remember that meeting before you saw me in the hallway? Do you remember what you were meeting about?
Offhand, there may have been several things on the agenda. I don't recall.
So where would I find the agenda for that meeting? Would it be on the internet? So, closed-door meeting, open meeting, was that a public meeting or not?
I don't remember.
Don't remember. If I had a recording of what was said there, would you be able to help me out with the transcript of what you were saying?
No, I don't think so.
No? Any reason you wouldn't want to help me out? I mean, because if I had recorded your voice, you would want it to be clear what you were saying and not have somebody else interpret it, right? Bill, I recorded the conversation, the whole thing that was going on in that closed-door meeting.
That was decent of you, wasn't it?
I don't think that's either here nor there. I think what's decent would be for you to say what went on at that meeting and maybe get that report released to the public because people really want to know. I think if you've got to redact some names or some personal information, that's fair enough, but city money was used to pay for this investigation, so the people should know. So your opinion is that it should not be released and the people should not know?
My opinion is that was privately authorized and obtained report.
Who authorized the report?
It was asked for by the CCDA.
Who specifically on the CCDA asked for it?
I expect it was a board decision.
So if it was a board decision, then the whole board is responsible. If it was a board decision, then the whole board would be responsible, right?
Well, it would be a board decision that they requested this report, yes.
Right, and so you were on the board when that was requested, right?
I think so. I'm not sure when I was appointed now.
So, as an individual board member, would you give your opinion on that? Like, are you saying that your personal opinion is that that report should not be released, or are you saying that that's what the board did and you just happened to be on the board?
That's the board decision.
So your personal opinion is different than the board or the same as the board?
I don't believe that that report should be
Why not? What about if we redacted personal information from that, just so people could read about it without having any personal information there? Would you think that would be appropriate?
No.
Why not?
Because I think it served its purpose, and the issue is closed.
The issue doesn't seem to be closed for some of the victims, though.
Well,
or, I guess we could say alleged victims at this point. Did you hear of any complaints, or are you still, I remember watching one of the city council meetings where you had said that there were no complaints substantiated. Are you still under the impression that there were no complaints ever substantiated?
Complaints of what?
Sexual harassment at the Monarch Theater.
There were allegations of sexual harassment.
How many?
And there was an investigation into that.
Do you know how many allegations there were? So nothing was substantiated, but there were allegations.
There were allegations.
Okay. And do you think that the full scope of the thing is completely closed and that we'll never hear anything about it again?
Well, as far as I'm concerned, the matter is concluded.
Okay. Is there anything else that you want to tell me about it at all, or?
I don't think so.
Okay. Thanks for your time, Bill.
Okay.
Bye-bye. Bill Cox didn't sound too happy with those questions, and I think you should go ahead and ask Bill Cox these same questions. Bill Cox, why are you on the CCDA, and why do you think it's inappropriate to release the findings of an investigation that may say something very, very, very bad about what is going on in our city? Just answer, man. Just answer. I mean, I can't stress enough how important it is that this report be released. And if information has to be redacted, that's obviously fine. We're not going to have people's personal phone numbers or, you know, addresses showing up in this kind of thing. But I think it's something that, you know, somebody will be able to do a Freedom of Information request and we'll get a copy of it that doesn't have, you know, all the info there, but it will have the story there so that the public can know exactly, you know, what went on and what the process was and where we are now. Thanks so much for watching.